Hi guys, today I'm gonna show you how to set up a basic Express app on your digital ocean droplet. We're going to install node.js, set up a basic Express app, set up PM2 process manager for node.js, set up Ubuntu's UFW firewall, install and configuring nginx, set up a domain on Namecheap and DigitalOcean, and last but not least, add SSL with Let's Encrypt. Let's get to it. I'm going to assume that you've already set up your droplet. If you haven't done that, I'm going to leave a link in the description in order to do that. So I'm just going to install node.js through NVM. It's a node version manager. Just need to go and grab this command. I've actually have it installed, so it's not going to do anything, as it says here. After this is done, you actually need to go and install node using this command over here, nvm install node. It's already installed for me. Now to set up our basic Express app. Just gonna make a directory called express underscore server. Gonna cd into it. Let's just see if npm is working. So we're gonna install express. Actually, we're gonna initialize a node project using npm init-y, which is gonna use a default configuration. And then we're gonna install express, npm install express. And after this is done, I'm actually gonna use VS Code using this remote extension, this one, remote SSH, which I've already have installed. I'm gonna connect to my droplet remotely. When you install the extension, you get an icon here. You click on that and you open the configuration file. It's this one over here, so it should be users, your username and SSH config. If you click on that, mine is already set up, but you can set up your droplet like this. Just use an alias, put in your IP address and your username. Now that I have it set up, I can actually connect to my droplet like this. Just need to give it a moment. So it's opening a remote connection. Now just to open the folder that we created is this Express server. Click OK. I'm just gonna create a file called index.js. And I'm gonna write the code for a basic Express app. Need express and run express to get an app. I'm going to run the server on port 3000. This command here actually listens for incoming connections. So I'm gonna use a template string. Let's see if our app is working, and I'm gonna set up a route and listen for GET requests on our root domain. And we're gonna send some very basic HTML. I need to do this so Express knows that we want to send HTML and not a plain string. Then I'm just gonna send an H2. Hello from stubborn code. This is it from our basic Express app code. We're now gonna install PM2. This is a process manager for Node.js apps, because otherwise we would need to run our app like this. In order to do that, I'm gonna do npm install -g, which is the global flag, PM2. I'm gonna give it some time to install, and with PM2 installed, we can see if it's working. Seems like it is. But the basic commands of PM2 would be PM2 start, file name. We see that the service is working. We can do PM2 list to list our apps. We can do PM2 stop and use the name of our service here. Can see now the status is stopped. You can do PM2 start to start it again. And if it's running and we want to restart it, we can do PM2 restart and the name of our service. We need to add one last thing in order for our apps to start again on system reboot, if the server restarts for whatever reason. So you can use this PM2 command, PM2 startup. Gonna give us a command to run to set up the startup script. I'm just gonna copy paste the command. So now we just need to save our process list, just to make sure that everything is running fine. Just do PM2 save, and that should be it. With our app running, we should be able to go and see it in the browser, right? So if I copy our droplet's IP address, port 3000, and it's not working. Why is that? Well, the thing is that we need to open the ports in the UFW firewall. In order to do that, you need a user account that's in the group of sudoers that gives you root privileges temporarily. So assuming that you have that set up, we can do sudo UFW status to see our ports. Type our password. We see that we only allow these ports right now. So what we can do is temporarily allow 3000 just to see if everything is working fine. And if we copy our address now at port 3000, we can see that our Express app is working. Let's go back and remove the rules. So we can do UFW status numbered, will give us a numbered set of rules. We can do UFW delete 4, which is this rule over here. Select yes, away. Delete 2, which was the other rule. And now we can go and allow connections to the usual port that HTTP and HTTPS are using, which are 80 and 443. With this added, we can now go and install nginx. To do that, we can update the apt package manager and install nginx. Yes. Now to check if the installation went fine. And we see that nginx is now active. If we now go to our IP address, we should see the nginx default landing page. Take the 3000 port out. And here it is. Now to set it up as a reverse proxy for our Express app. To do that, we're going to edit nginx default configuration file, which can be found here. Default. We only have one server block. Under location, we just add proxy underscore pass, HTTP, localhost, and then the port that our app is running on, which is 3000. Since we're using a domain name, we should also include that next to the server name option. In this case, it's funcode.space. And I also want to include the www version. Control X to save. Y. Just to check if the configuration is fine. So then the next does T. It seems like everything is fine. So just restart our service and the next service. And we should be able to see our Express service. And we do. Last step, set up our domain. So I have this amazing domain name, Namecheap. This is already set up. In order to set this up, you just go to name servers, click on custom DNS, and add the DNS servers of DigitalOcean, which are these three. ns1.digitalocean.com, the same with ns2 and ns3, and then add the same domain name on DigitalOcean. To do that, you go to DigitalOcean, click on networking, enter your domain, add a domain, we already have the name servers from Namecheap here. If you just added the domain on Namecheap, you should give it a bit of time in order to propagate. It says up to 48 hours. I found that it's usually takes a few minutes, 10, 15 minutes, maybe half an hour. And then you need to create two-way records. Just to add for your root domain. Select your droplet, create record, and the www of your domain. Select again your droplet and create this record. And with your domain name set up, just need to add the SSL certificate. We're going to do that through certbot. We're using nginx and Ubuntu 18.04. I have already installed certbot, so I'm not actually gonna do it again, but I'm gonna leave a link in the description with this website so you can find the commands and run them. So I'm just gonna run this command to get our SSL certificate and edit our nginx configuration file automatically as well. So we can leave it blank to select all options. I'm just gonna reinstall the certificate since I've already installed it. We're gonna redirect all requests to HTTPS. Let's see if everything's working. And you can see the log here. The connection is secure. We've managed to set everything up with an SSL certificate. That was all for today. I'll see you in the next video.